Okay, let's take a question from Kirk. What is your succession plan with Launch Twist and why? Good question. Also, what other syndicates do you admire and why? Okay. In terms of other syndicates, let me think that through. Ed Roman has a great one. A lot of people have turned off their syndicates and started funds. So I don't know if there are actually that many more syndicates doing individual deals. I think like we're one of the last people standing. My succession plan with Launch and Twist, I don't worry about that. I don't think about that all too much. I just think about working hard. With This Week in Startups, I feel that's my life's work. I have been thinking about getting a co-host to do 10 episodes a year, or maybe do the news roundtables every time. Because in the all-in podcast, people are like, oh, Chamath and Jason, we both have a similar Twitter following, a couple hundred thousand followers. So when Chamath tweets an all-in episode, I tweet an all-in episode, the all-in episodes sometimes spike ahead of This Week in Startups. So if I could land somebody like Kara Swisher to do episodes with me, she's obviously got escape velocity and has all of her own shows. I would consider it because if there was somebody with at least as many followers as me, or maybe half as many, 100,000, 200,000, and who brought another audience to the table, I would really love that because it would take a little pressure off me and then move the show up. I'd be willing to pay some really great co-host a decent amount of cash to do it. It'd be a very lucrative gig for them, and it would be great for us because it could increase the audience size. So I'd love to have somebody who's different than me, a different life experience. A lot of people said, hey, how about a person of color? How about a female? Yes, would be my thinking as well. And somebody who can bring audience. That's really what I want, is somebody who can bring audience and spread the word about This Week in Startups. In terms of Launch, I have two amazing managing directors in Jackie and Ashley and a team right behind them who are up and coming. I think I'll work for another two decades until I'm 70, and sure, at that point, maybe I'll hand it over to that team and they run it. Or maybe I'll work another 10 years and then hand it over to them if I want to retire early. But I try not to think about that. I think it's super narcissistic to think like about empire building. I like to think about today, this week, this month, right? I like to think in the short and the near term. I do set some long-term goals, like being the greatest investor of all time, being the greatest angel investor of all time. I like to set some goals like that personally for myself. I don't talk about them too much. And I also don't obsess on too much. I just make a plan. In order to be the greatest investor of all time, I would need to have more unicorn investments worth more money than Bill Gurley or Michael Moritz and Doug Leone, or, you know, Jim Breyer at Excel, you know, Kosla. Just pick the person who's got an incredible career. And so, you know, I would look at that and say, well, how did they do it? Well, they found great companies. Okay. How do you find great companies? Well, you make an investment. One strategy would be to make 100 investments a year and then double, triple, quadruple down on the top 10, 20% of them, which is exactly what I'm doing. If I can invest in 100 investments a year, maybe 200 someday, over a decade, I could, you know, have 1,000 more investments on top of the 250 I've done. If the statistics hold up, yeah, maybe that means I have more unicorns than anybody's ever invested in. Or maybe the top three investors combined wouldn't have as many unicorns. So I'm thinking big, but I also don't obsess about it. And I feel like I've won already. And any reasonable person, when they've done that, maybe it takes the edge off. So I'm pretty happy with where I am. I don't think too much about legacy, the future. I do think about, gosh, I enjoy going to work every day. If I wake up and I don't want to go to work, that's a terrible feeling, right? And I know what that's like. I've worked for other people and just woke up and dreaded going to the office. So I am just staying away from that feeling and leaning into the feeling I love, which is doing this podcast, hanging out with you all in thisweekinstartups.com/Slack, our private Slack room, doing the accelerator, doing remotedemoday.com. You know, when I do those projects or I write a book and I do the episodes of this podcast, man, I feel great. I think you all know that because you hear the tone of my voice. Man, this is my dream job. I just pinch myself that a kid from Brooklyn gets to do this every day.